Panel data consists in observations of the same individuals over time. In this video, we introduce a simple model and discuss its limitations. It will be the motivation to introduce more complex models. The type of data that we have used so far is called cross-sectional. It's the observation of many individuals at a given point in time. We have another type of data in statistics called time series, where you take one variable and you have a sequence of observations of this variable over time. Well, panel data is basically the combination of the two. This is a combination of comparable time series. It means that all the variables that are involved in the analysis are observed over time. This is what we refer to as panel data. So in short, this is data collected over multiple time periods for the same sample of individuals. So this is a typical representation of panel data. We have an index for the individuals that we denote by n, and an index for time. So time can be minutes, hours, day, months, depending on the context. And then for each individual and each period of time, we have the values of the explanatory variables, x, and the value of the choice, I. So as you can see, both x and I, we have two indices, n and t. So this example refers to choices related to stocks in a portfolio management. So at each day, each individual is faced with the price of two stocks and may decide to buy stock one, stock two, or none at all. And this is the decision which is represented here. So I purchase stock one. When it is two, I purchase stock two. And if it is zero, I don't purchase any of the stocks. So the four first rows here in this example are associated with individual one. So individual one on day one decides to buy stock one, on day two to buy stock two, on day three to buy stock two, and on day four not to buy anything. And then I have the same observation for individual two and so on. The sequence of choices that people make, so here I have 1, 2, 2, 0, I will call this a trajectory. So remember, in the classical choice models estimated on cross-sectional data, we were associating an individual with a choice probability because each individual made only one choice. In the context of panel data, we will associate each individual with a trajectory probability. So what is the probability that my model predicts the trajectory, the sequence of choices that this individual has made? There are plenty of examples of discrete panel data in the literature. So for example, you can have people being interviewed every month to check if they are working or not. So this is designed to analyze the labor market and the dynamics of the labor market. You can also track firms every year to check if they have been acquired or if they have been merged with another firm. In marketing, you can interview consumers every year to check if they have bought a new smartphone or not. This is also used in the context of medicine, where you can record every year the decisions that people make with respect to their health. In the video about latent variables, I've introduced a drawing convention for the variables in my model. The idea is that an oval shape represents a latent variable. In this case, this is the utility. The rectangular shape represents the observed variable. We have x, which are the explanatory variables, and I, which is the dependent variable, the choice. And then we have the error term epsilon. So this is the pictorial representation of a choice model at a given single time period. Now I have access to data covering multiple time periods. So something that I can do, which is very easy, is to duplicate this model for each time period that I have. So that's what I have done in this slide. I have simply duplicated the specification and associated each of them with a different index, t. So this is the model for time interval t, and I have exactly the same specification for time interval t minus 1. So this is very simple. I just take panel data, and I just duplicate my model across time intervals. This is called the static model. Let's write the equation. The utility specification of the static model involves three indices, the alternative and the individual, I and n, but now we have also t, which is the time period. And as we did for the choice model with cross-sectional data, we separate the utility into a deterministic part, capital V, and a random term, epsilon. So a convenient assumption would be to assume that epsilon I and t are extreme value distributed, and they are IID. Remember, IID independent and identically distributed across all dimensions. So across I, across n, but also across t, across time. If we do this assumption, the model is a logit model. As I discussed before, when we want to estimate these models, we need to write the likelihood function, and it consists in calculating the probability that the trajectory of an individual, the observed trajectory, is predicted by our model. So the probability of the trajectory, so IN1 until IN capital T, so the sequence of all the choices performed by individual N, well, because of the independence assumption that we have done, this is simply the product of all individual probability. So the probability that the person makes the first choice, the second choice, until the last choice, which is capital T. So this is nothing else than the product over T of the choice probability. And when you take the log, whereby you get simply the log of the product being the sum of the log. So this is straightforward, isn't it? So somehow what we do here is to consider panel data as just additional data in a cross-sectional setting. Okay, we don't exploit at all the fact that they are related with time. So it's extremely simple, which makes the analysis very simple as well, but it has limitations, and we will have to understand these limitations. So as I said, this technique is viewing the observations that are panel as supplementary cross-sectional observation. So we can use everything that we have seen in the past. It can be used directly. And we need to look at the limitations. There are two major limitations. The first one is called serial correlation. Remember, we have assumed that the epsilons are independent across I, across N, and across T, across all the dimensions. But if you think about it, the fact that it's the same individual that is performing the choice, well, there are factors which are unobserved, which will be the same every day, every time we observe the individual. Any preference, any bias towards any alternative, anything that matters but which is not observed, will be in the epsilon. And because it's the same individual, this part will be persisting over time. So this unobserved factors persisting over time, this is called serial correlation. And here, we look at these factors related to individual N, the fact that the individual does not change too much over time. Therefore, the assumption that we made that these epsilons were independent across time may not be valid. The second thing is that we completely ignore the dynamics of the system. In particular, whenever I perform choices. I learn something. Also, I have some habits. Okay, if I used to travel by public transportation every morning, it's not that I wake up every morning and make a choice, calculate the cost, calculate the travel time. No, I have some habits. So I do prefer things just because I used to prefer them. And if you don't take this into account, the history of the choices, you may miss something. And these are the two major limitations of this static model. We ignore serial correlation and we ignore dynamics. And we will have to address these two limitations. In this video, we have introduced the concept of panel data. A model that considers this panel data as supplementary cross-sectional data is called the static model. It has two major limitations. It does not deal with serial correlation, and it does not deal with dynamics. In the next videos, we address these two limitations one at a time and then together.